Welcome everybody. I can see that people are still joining. This is why we said we would like to have a login time of 10 minutes before the webinar. So welcome to this first IEC webinar, the first webinar we created. You received a mail to join this webinar, but we also have created a platform for webinars on the IEC website. You can find it going to, you see this down here, IECCH Academy. And today we will talk about the new IEC collaboration platform. With me today is Cyril Vanas. He is the project manager, the IT project manager for this project, Francesco Corbetta, who is the web architect for this project, and myself, Jan-Henrik Tiedemann, I'm the business owner for this project. We are excited to show you something today, and let's just start. We don't have a vocal question because we have over 100 participants who registered for this meeting. This might be a bit of a kerfuffle or a bit of a if we allow this, so, but you can ask questions anytime using the questions function here in GoToWebinar, and depending on the question, we will answer it directly when you have a question during the presentation, or if it's a more common question, we will have a question and answers at the end of the webinar. Further to that, we are recording this, so people who cannot participate, or if you want to later on rehear this, this will be available on the same website, so where you logged in, we will have the possibility that you can see this. Also, you can find here in your window, in your webinar window, the slides, so you can download the slides directly from this place. And yes, let's start it now. It's a rather cloudy day morning here in Geneva. So it's a great way to sit in and listen to this presentation, the new IEC collaboration platform. First of all, this is the first part of a larger project the IEC is doing. The IEC is looking into new ways of creating standards, and we sent a while ago already, we sent a strategy created by Peter Godwin, the head of strategy and IT strategy, about how can standardization be done in the future. So we developed a concept, the IEC Future Standards Development and Business Platform, which you can find following this link here. And in there it is explained how we want to do standardization in the future, mainly working online, how things are connected, to see how content development can be connected, how we can better integrate vertically integrate the things we have, the tools we have for a better content management and for much better solutions and a more convenient way of working. So this is the first part of the IEC Future Standards Development and Business Platform, this IEC collaboration platform, which will then seamlessly and vertically integrate in all the other services we will develop in the coming years. So it's a start of an exciting project also for us. Why do we start with the collaboration part of this project? Well, the existing collaboration tools are in place already since 2007. It's a long time for software, it's 10 years, and if you remember the phone you had 10 years ago, you can imagine how fast things are evolving. So we have to do something with the IBM collaboration tool suite, that was the software we used. And the collaboration tools, this is a workspace for our technical committees, for working groups, maintenance team, project teams, but also for conformity assessment and for a lot of other groups using the collaboration tools for exchanging documents, for discussion, for assigning tasks, for assigning issues, solving issues hopefully. And we also offer this tool to national committees who could use this tool free of additional cost on a national way, which was a good advantage for us and for the national committees, because if people use it already on a national level, of course, when they join the IEC, then they don't need a training on this tool. So this is a tool, the IBM collaboration tool suite, which we are using right now. And we have around 30,000 users on this platform, So why do we do this? We need to have a business continuity, and this IBM tool has its end of life phase, which means it's no longer supported by IBM, so we need to change the tool. There's a more or less urgent need to change this tool. So this is why we had this project started, and first time we did something completely new with this project. We created a reference group of users. So a reference group is a group of using an agile way of working, so we no longer create a large level of requirements at the beginning, and then we work the project behind closed doors, and then we show you this is what we want to have, or this is what we did. But we, at any time of the project, we involved users. So this reference group was open, and it's a hands-on informal group of now over 60 users giving input, recommendations at any time, at any step of the project, so to help us creating this new tool. And this CTS reference group, I say CTS reference group because we also have reference group for other projects, like for example for the XML project. The CTS reference group, there was a call for participation in April 2016, and all its activities have been communicated in the blog, in the ITNet blog. This is a blog which is open for secretaries, for officers of technical committees, subcommittees, conformity assessment, and national committees, and for people who are interested in what the IEC is developing. So if you have a certain interest and a need participating here, you can drop us a mail for ITNet. This is a technical thing. You can see what we do right now. So coming back to the CTS reference group, seven workshops have been done between 2016 and 2017. And in these 17 workshops, you see one example here. That was a live workshop during the general meeting in Frankfurt. But we did mainly also the workshops online, so to make sure that many people can participate. And here we had discussions, we had improvements, and we got a lot of good input from the participants, not only because also why the CTS reference group is already using the new collaboration platform for test and discussion. So as soon as we had the first stage of this collaboration platform ready, we migrated the CTS reference group and they could test it, and we used it for working, so they could experience the first pain point and solve all these points. How did we work together? We worked agile, and for those of you who didn't hear about agile so far, agile is different from the waterfall method of creating projects. Waterfall method is that we write a catalog of requirements at the very beginning of the project, and then we work all of them, and then we have the final product. And other than that, the agile process is that we have some requirements, and these requirements we discuss with a group, in this case with the CTS reference group, all 4 weeks, and then we can say this is a good way, or do we change the way. So we develop a project along with the users, which has the big advantage that at any time of the project we can change according to what the users need, so the users can say, oh no, we didn't mean this, we mean it more like that. So to really ensure that the product we create is really made for the users which will use the product later on. So this is one example here of discussions. This was the CTS workshop in Frankfurt, and here people were discussing about the user interface. A little bit about the structure of this project. So we structured the project that all participants can give input in the CTS reference group, which is open to join for everybody who has a certain interest in this. Here we have a business owner, this is myself, collecting all these requirements and then discussing in a sprint review this with our agile project manager who is here today. I introduced him, Cyril Vanas, and this is then discussed with the IT development. So this ensures that at any stage of the project, the users stay involved and make sure that we develop into the right direction. So this is now the IT side. Here you can see the IT team discussing, okay, this is a bit staged, but this is how we discuss in the background. This is a serious, it's a weekly or it's a daily stand-up, I think. It's a daily stand-up, so daily stand-up, daily discussions on how to move forward with the team. So you can see it's a very agile way of working. Okay, enough about this. I want to give you a little bit, if you imagine a car, this is now opening up the engine. Here I show what we decided to use for the CTS Next, for the IEC collaboration platform. And this is the technology we are using. So as the front end, as the user interface, we are using a technology called Angular, which has been decided to be best for robust and economic web applications. This is supported by many organizations. It's active since 2009. And a big advantage is that there was a new major version released in 2017. So this is an open source software used by many organizations, like, for example, the United Nations. So we are very sure that this is a good and flexible user interface for all the functions we want to do, all the services we want to create with the new business standards business and development platform. And as a back end, we again use open source software. So we use a software called Drupal 8. This is a modular content management software development framework. And this is one of the largest and most active open source software with a very big community supporting this, which means we will see a lot of functionalities developed by the community, a lot of possibilities we can have here, how we can evolve this together with our reference group. It's active since 2001, but it doesn't mean that it's nothing changed since then. There's a lot of changes, a lot of development, and again, a new major version has been released in 2017. There's around 15K new Drupal 8 sites a month, so you can see a lot of companies start using this open source software. So we checked a lot of different technologies, and we are very sure that this is future-proof and a very good possibility, a good framework which enables us to do a lot more services in the future. Now I talked about the phase one, the business continuity. So this new IEC collaboration tools suite will be introduced in several phases. The first phase will replace the tool, the CTS we're having right now, with the existing set of functions. So it's very important that what we will be introducing now doesn't show the full product, but it is just replacing the existing services so we can continue working the way we do, but just with a larger framework with a lot of possibilities, which is future-proof. So the first thing we are doing in this first phase in the early 2018 is to ensure business continuity in a way that you can continue working the way you do without any obstacles. So we will migrate all the content from the existing CTS into the new IEC collaboration tools, collaboration platform, and provide the existing functionalities, file sharing, discussion, notifications, and address the key user issues. So everything which has been complicated, everything which has been announced or discussed in the CTS reference group will be solved, and we will introduce these changes. And the new thing is that we offer an easy-to-use user interface, because we heard that, yeah, of course, it's from 2007, the old software, so there are better possibilities for user interfaces. Another change, and this might be a bit complex, but I want to explain it, is that at the current CTS, the current collaboration tools, we are working in a wiki-centric way. And a lot of you discussing this with you said it's quite complicated because it's very different from the way you work with other tools. So what you had to do in the CTS is that you have to create a page, and then you can add documents to the page. So for all the documents, you cannot exchange or discuss documents, but you always had to create a page, and then you could put documents. So we call it a wiki-centric way, but it's not very much like the way we used to work with other tools in our daily life. So the challenge was that we had to create a page to upload documents, that discussions we could use were not linked to this page and not linked to the document. So the basic document management features were missing. It was impossible to search, to organize, to archive and manage versioning at the document level. And of course, this caused a lot of obstacles, so some of the committees prefer to send documents per mail, which is not good because we want to archive documents. We want to also, for new people joining the working groups, want to enable them to see all the documents in one place. So this was our pain point, which we wanted to change with a new tool. So we decided to move from the wiki-centric way to a document-centric way of working, which means a structured file management system to collect metadata for documents, which we can later use for workflows, for example, and for other functionalities, for archiving, and to have integrated document-related discussions. So you can really start collaborating on a document. And this document-centric way of working has a file manager which directly links to document discussions. We will see this later on. I will also have a live show. There will be a preview possibility of PDF and other Office documents. And finally, this has been requested a long time, we have multiple downloads with a zip creation. One thing I have to mention here, when I introduced the CTS reference group working, I forgot to say that before doing this, we ask all of you to send us your user stories. We, in before April 2016, we ask you to send how do I work right now and what would I like to change. So we had around 300 user stories which gave us all these ideas from the community. What are the pain points, what are the issues we need to change. And this zip creation, multiple downloads, was one of these pain points you issued to us, you mentioned to us. Then we have a document-centric file upload wizard. So this means you can drag and drop files in here, multiple files, and you have a metadata collection. Again, I will go more into details with this during the live presentation of this tool. Then I have we have document discussions, so these are visible from the file manager. There are multiple multiple things, and here we have multiple topic threads, not just comments. So just to say. So. Document-centric way of working, and we have discussion forums. So we noticed that in the CTS, all the discussions started, so people tried using the discussions, but then they stopped. After a few weeks, people stopped using the discussions, and we asked people why. And they said that the discussions are complicated to use, so we really looked into a possibility of how we can have a better way of discussing, because discussing is what you would like to do. Here we have subject-related discussions, and we have attachment linked to files in the document manager. So documents don't get lost in a discussion, but you always refer to a document which is stored in a folder with metadata. So you will never have any documents flying around, but they will all be in a context. And this is very important for document management, obviously. So this slide is summarizing what we did so far. So we created intuitive dashboards with some short links, a preview of documents, multiple downloads. We created the drag and drop file upload with multiple files and with metadata collection. And connected to this, we create document-centric discussions with multiple topic threads and not just comments. So you can see that it's all in line, it's all connected, and it has a very logical approach of connection. All these functions are connected. They all lead to the same document, the documents lead to the same discussion, so it's easy to use, easier to use, and it's connected. This is what we will introduce for the first migration, but of course later on in the following year, we will have the possibility to hand-in-hand with the CTS, with the CTS reference group, to add more functions as these are required. But about this I will speak a little bit later. I would like now to show to give a live presentation of this test platform of the new IEC collaboration platform. For this, I quickly step out of the presentation and go into the browser. So this is a test platform, and I'm logging in with my IEC login. So this test platform, there's at the moment only access to the reference group, to the CTS reference group. So if you try this, you might not be able to log in. What you see here is your login, your username, password. So it will be, it is the email address here for the test. Of course, you have the forgot password, and I'm signing in right now. And the first thing you see is the dashboard. And here, this dashboard will be personalized, so you will see your participation. And for this test platform, we decided to show you a person who is working in the IEC, of course, who is having a national committee which is also using the collaboration tools. So as said, if a national committee wants, we offer a hosting of the collaboration tools for a national committee. And since Belgium, the Belgium National Committee is using this service at the moment, we just added this to the test platform. And of course, Senelec is also using the collaboration tools. So this would be a person working at the IEC level, using it on a national level, and also participating in the European level. So what you see here is what your data in the IEC expert management are. So if you participate here, you will only see IEC. If you have more participation, you will see more. Here you can see your notifications, so everything personalized to your participation, the latest notifications you can see here, and it will show new if there's any new notifications. Then you will have your profile here. You have a possibility to log out here. So this is your regular content management. Then what you can see here is you have my workspaces. So this will combine all the workspaces you have, all access to workspaces. A workspace is, for example, a technical committee. Then you have the possibility my favorites, and in here you can, if you are frequently going to a committee or to a folder, you can add a favorite, and then you can always directly go here. So you can see I set two favorites to two different committees. Then you will have my tasks, my document, my calendar, my settings. And since this is project is agile, we don't have this yet, so this is faded out, but this will be developed along the process, so there will be more development coming. I will now log into or just click on IEC, and you can see here that I have an admin access, so I will see all the files and folders. I just quickly want to show how you navigate here. So I use TC150 as a test committee to show you how I can navigate. So you can either click on the committee, or if you just want to go to one of the subgroups, you can click onto the arrow, and then you can see you can quickly go to one of the subcommittees. So you have this possibility of navigation, and you can see although I have an admin access to all these groups, and this is a test platform, this system is really quick. Then if you scroll up, you can click on this, and it will always go back to your choice. So there are some nice features on here. So this is one example of how you can navigate between different groups. And now going back to my dashboard, I go to my favorites, and I want to show you the working area of the CTS reference group. So this is the working area of the CTS reference group, but this could also be a technical committee or conformity assessment area. And here, first of all, I see the dashboard, the committee dashboard, and this one here is, yeah, you see on the dashboard you see the documents, the discussion sub workspace, you see some recent activity, and there's also another way of going to this. So if, for example, I want to search for this, I can type on CTS, and then I can directly go to this here. So you can, it has an intelligent search. So there are also other ways of going to this. So you can use also the search function. Then here you can quickly reach, yeah, so this is the dashboard here, as I said. We will add more to this dashboard, so we are working on this, so you will also, for example, have a list of members in the committee. This was something which has been frequently requested by the user stories, but also by the CTS reference group, that you can see who is actually in my committee and can I contact this person and can I see maybe if this person is online. So you will have a list of the current participants directly taken from the expert management system, because this, of course, will be contacted to the expert management system. So there will be no change to roles. We will just use exactly the same roles and access you already have by using the expert management system. Going to documents, here you can see everything related to documents, and just by going to test cases, I can use this folder structure here, clicking on test cases and clicking on archives, and then I can show you the fourth workshop, for example. And in here you can see that a lot has been already worked on and discussed. So this is all the real work of the CTS reference group, all the discussions which have been done, all the people who participated in here. So a lot of work has been done here. And I will go back now to the higher level, and then I will navigate to the file list, to the presentation. So I can click here also, navigate here, go to the presentations, and here on the presentations you can see there's one presentation which has been listed, so we also published the presentations. And I mentioned before that we have these quick actions. So the quick actions are really convenient if you just quickly want to do something. So here you can see in the quick actions that there has been a discussion on this document, so 16 people have discussed on the document. Then you have the possibility to quickly view the document. So although it's a large presentation, I will click on this, and I hope it works. Of course it works, you see. Here you see the presentation opening, and you can browse through the presentation. So without downloading it, you can quickly see what this document is. So this is convenient, and we had some good comments from the CTS reference group about this. Then you have the possibility to download this, and you also have the possibility to see some details. So you can we can click on the details level now, and here we see some metadata. So you can see a direct link, you can see the title, you can see if there's discussions related to this document, you can download the document. So this gives all the details about the documents, including the PDF. So here you have all the metadata combined, and you can enlarge on this if you want to work with this. So there are quite some convenient functions with this. Just click it away again and you're back to the list of documents. Now I would like to go to the discussions level, and on the discussions level here you can see that there's two different ways of discussion. So we have a general discussions which we can create. We can create new topics, and here we started using the discussions with introduce yourself. So you can see here introduce yourself, and there were the group was testing it by introducing themselves. So again, you can open this if you want to have more space to go through this, to read through this. And this is one possibility to have a discussion. And yeah, just open it, have a look here to the discussions. Maybe we can open one discussion here. So you can see my favorite website is IACCH. I'm kidding, I hope not, from Ivano Wiesentainer. So this is a general discussion, and now I can open documents here from the discussion, but I go back to the main topics. Now for download, I go back to the documents here, and I want to show you a little bit about the download function. So I go to the demonstration folder, because here we have quite some documents. And the download I mentioned before has become quite convenient. You know, at the current system you have to download one by one, and here you have the possibility of choosing different documents or choose all. And then here you can see how many documents you were choosing, and then you can just download all of them conveniently in a zip file. Depending on your rights, you can also delete these, but of course not everybody can delete documents, so this is depending on the rights which are already in the expert management system. Now I click on download file, and then there will be a zip file created, so I just simply save it, and when I open it you can see that these documents have been prepared in a zip file for your convenience. So this is the possibility of downloading documents, and in the same, I want to show you how to upload a document. For uploading documents, you then of course go to the upload icon, and here you now have the possibility to drag and drop. So I prepared some documents we can drag and drop. So I have this draft agenda as a doc file and as a PDF. So I just take both of them and I drag and drop them into this window. Then they are uploading, and then this is now what we described with metadata. So now as a next step I go to describe, and with describe I can add a set, I can add the metadata. Here for the metadata, at the moment we have a default of metadata, but we can of course add several types of metadata. So we can have per committee, if it's a TC or working group, we can have a different set of metadata. We can have a different set of metadata deciding if it's an agenda or if it's any other type of document. And we can also have a different set of metadata per organization. And here we just use one example. For example, if it would be Senelec using it, and Senelec has different business requirements, we would have a different set of metadata. For example, here we would have a deadline for the document. So we can develop by we can develop different set of metadata. So here now I add the title into the document. I click on finish, and then I have the document uploaded. So now you can see the document here, draft agenda, PDF, and draft. So this is how you upload a document. You can upload one or more documents, but as mentioned before, you no longer create a page, but you upload a document. So you upload a document, and then with this document you can have a discussion connected to the document, or you can have different functions. Oops, that was my pen, sorry. So as a next, I would like to go one step further to the right here on the dashboard and go to discussions. So we already talked about the discussions, and I would like to create a new topic now and show you how the discussion works. So here I go to new topic, and I can create a new title. So that's just creating a title, and here I can attach documents, and I will do this now. I attach documents. So for attaching documents, this is very important, because attaching documents, at the current system, if we attach documents, they are just connected to the discussion, but you don't find them anywhere else. So what we did here is that we can attach documents from folders. So I can go to a folder, I can say I want this and this, and I can also upload a new document, and use a new document. So I say confirm, I have these attached. I can attach more document, and if I have this open, I want to attach a document which is not already existing in a folder. I will choose the folder where I want to put the document, and then I will go to upload and upload a new document. For example, this responsibility list, I will update, I would put it here. I will describe it because we need metadata with the document so we can handle this. And you can see two things at the same time. The document has been added to the folder and the document has been added to the download. So like this, we have no longer lost documents in discussions, but we have a proper home for the documents. We have a proper set of metadata for the documents. So you can see the big plus of document management, which has happened here. Now we have the question, we have the document attached, and I can create the topic. So this is now the topic created. And it is, in here, where should we meet next time? Of course, it was here. So if I go here now, I have this, I can see the attachments, I can download them one by one, I can download them as a zip file. If I want to reply to this, I can enlarge on the screen, and I can even make it larger, and then I can type some text here, so I can type a reply. I type Vienna because this will be the next meeting location of the SMB meeting. So I can type my reply here, and this is how easy discussions function. So you have a very easy way of replying to discussions. You have a possibility to attach documents, and the documents will still be in a folder and will still have a proper set of metadata. So this is how you do the discussions. The last thing I would like to show you is the online content. So I go back to, let's go to the demonstration folder. No, let's go to the release notes, because this is a good example of online content. One thing we did for every new release of this software, explaining to the CTS reference group what has been done, is that we created this, which is an HTML file, these release notes. And I will open the release notes so you can see Christmas release. You can see the different releases from the very beginning, what has been done so far. And this content is an online document. So this has been created online. This is not a Word file. So here you can click on edit, and then you can directly work in this and directly exchange this document and work on this document. So one example here, I would like to just simply create a new online document, a new content. So I click on new content. That was maybe a bit quick. So I go back here, new content. I click on this. I can give it a title. And the big advantage is that I can use templates for this online content. And one example we put here to show you is a meeting report. Probably you know that in the ad hoc group 67, the SMB ad hoc group, there was a discussion about meeting reports, and this ad hoc group prepared a meeting report template, and we added the template here. So here you can see now that we can use a template which facilitates the creation of a template quite well. And now we can start working on the template Vienna. I just add one, and then I can write this, and I click on save and close. And like this, I can create online content. So you can see meeting in Vienna. I can download this. I can open a discussion on this. I can continue working on this. So this is, at the moment, a very simple way of how we create online content. Of course, at the moment, it's a very simple way, so we are still working on this. We are gaining experience with this, and we will implement also the current and foreseen document management features such as metadata sets, versioning, and discussions with this. And very important to say, the editor component will implement iteratively validated prototype functionalities. So more and more we do will be online content, and this is just one example. But of course, as I mentioned before, in the standardization business platform, development and business platform, we will also have online content available, and we will go into online creation of standards. So by this, I would like to finish this little live presentation, unless there's some direct questions related to this, Cyril. Is there anything? Okay. Okay. All answered. So you can see that's a good example of teamwork. I'm talking and Cyril is working. Very good. Okay, let's go back to the presentation. The challenging thing, what we did is in December 2017, we started the first development phase with a staging platform, the platform which I showed right now, and we started to migrate content to validate this content. And now, right now in January, we are migrating the existing content of the CTS, of all the committees, to the test platform and do quality checks to see how does the content which you were using in the CTS right now, how does it display in the new platform? How are the functions integrating? And this is done by the IT project team at the moment. And in the same time, from December to March, we are doing a one-to-one communication with all CTS business groups. CTS business groups, we call it like this because obviously we don't do only TCSC standardization, but we also have conformity assessment using the platform. We have national committees using the platform. So what we did is we contacted all the users or the owners of these platforms, Senelec. We contacted the national committees. We contacted the technical officers who are responsible for the technical committees, and we asked them for some examples of a complex technical committee, a complex folder, and we are migrating this, and then in a one-to-one we will discuss to make sure that this content is perfectly migrated. We let them validate this, and as soon as this has been validated by the technical officers, the technical officers will contact the TCSC officers, meaning the TC secretary and the chair. And then as soon as this has been validated, then in the end of March, beginning of April, we will migrate all content together to the production platform. So all the content will be migrated at once. And then the old CTS, so no worries, the old collaboration tools will stay accessible in a read-only mode till the end of Q4 2018, so till the end of the year 2018, so that you can check if the content is proper and you can go back to have a look if everything works fine. And then the business groups will start working on the production version of the new IEC collaboration platform from April 2018. And start working now. I explained about different functionalities. We put the focus on that you can use the existing functionalities. So there will be not a big set of new functions in there, but you will keep more or less the same functions you had in the old tool. And before you ask, so why do you migrate? Of course, the new tool offers a framework to add more and more functions. And while we migrate all the content, and you can start working from April 1, we will continue to work in an agile way with the CTS reference group to see what other functions do you need, what else is important. And in the background, of course, we will continue working on the IEC standards development and business platform, and there will be more and more vertical integrations also with the other tools. So this is a start of a new functions, new tools, and I'm looking around here, we are all very excited about this new tool because it offers a lot of things, it solves a lot of pain points, And it's challenging, and it's quite a positive work for us. So to give you a little bit more view to the horizon, I want to show you now what we plan to do in 2017, 2018, 2019. So 2017, we worked on the core functionalities for the existing users, document management, discussions, notifications. This all happened in 2017, and notifications, we are still doing some work. Then 2018, now the beginning, we are doing the change management. So we are having right now, as explained, the validation period, and we will switch to the new platform by the end of March, beginning of April. And from then on, we have the possibility to extend functionalities to the whole community, to the whole IEC community. So we will be working on an online content creation platform integration, a long collection of words. In principle, it means that we are looking into online creation of standards. We will have a better integration with standards development project management processes with a project management tool. And we are looking into real-time communication services, which in principle is something which we are using right now. So we are looking into possibilities of integrating this, or possibilities of how we can better have a vertical integration to these services. And then in 2019, we plan to have a fully integrated online experience. So this is when we plan to have more functions with the IEC Standards Development and Business Platform, rich interfaces enabling with member systems, so that you also can connect with your existing systems on a national committee level, and a good integration of the standards development project management processes. So I talked a lot about the online content creation platform, and Francesco Corbetta, who's in the room, is taking the lead on this. This is at the moment we started the prototype. Now in 2018 we will be looking into core functionalities of an online content creation, of online standards creation, and in 2019 we will complete the integration. This is the plan. We will look into new services and into extended functionalities of this interesting possibility, interesting chance for working online. So this is the 3 years roadmap. You can see we have a lot on our plate. We have a lot to work. And looking into this plan, of course, it means that at any time, as CTS reference group, the national committees, the TCSC officers have their say, have a possibility of giving us ideas, looking into new functions. So we do this together with you using the reference group. And we will continue working in an agile way. We will continue giving these webinars to show you where we are, so you stay informed and nothing will happen. You will not be taken by surprise. So this was the presentation I wanted to give you, or we prepared. And of course, it's not only me. I'm just the voice here, but there are a lot of people in the background. So Cyril's team did a lot of work doing this. So there are is a team of IT specialists working on this. The reference group did a lot of work by participating. So thank you very much to everybody who participated so far in the CTS reference group. Without you, we couldn't have gone so far in creating this platform. And yeah, so we are open for questions now. The floor is open, and I give the mic to Cyril, who in the background already replied on a lot of questions. Cyril, are there questions right now coming in?
There was a lot, so I answered part of them, and some I kept for now. First one is from Ralph Sporer. How does this integrate with XML? If you can get one slide behind.
Yes, I will go one slide back. So here we are.
Yeah, so the answer to that question is sitting on the online content creation platform. The XML, simple XML will be used to store what is created online with that tool. and or with that component, not a platform, is a component that will be integrated on the collaboration platform when it will be ready. So really the XML is, we have an XML conversion project that is converting all our catalog to this XML format. Regarding the collaboration platform, the XML will be produced when we will move forward with an integrate inside the collaboration platform, the online content creation component. So you could start to see XML on the platform end of 2018.
Okay, just for the XML, I wanted to say that also for the XML we have a reference group, so here we also have users working on this, and the XML project of course is another part of this platform for all of you who didn't hear about this. So it's another part of the platform, and here we are working together so that the standards we create online will be available in XML, which of course then enables a lot of other products and a lot of other possibilities. So this is another important part of the standards development and business platform we are working on right now. Okay, other questions?
Okay, we have another question from Roland Hill, who is asking for if we will offer email address per team channel. We are currently looking into the notifications, into how you will send the message and it will broadcast it to your workspace or to the support of your workspace. So we are currently looking into that. Now what we would like is to ensure, you know, it's a new platform, so to ensure that our users come onto the platform and collaborate on the platform. So we have postpone the analysis of allowing you to send a mail without having to log into the platform and the mail being passed on the platform, etc., etc. What we don't like here is that how we'll address all the potential attachments, and as Jan said before, on our document management, we would like that any files you push on the platform is archived on the proper folder with proper metadata, and opening to parsing a mail you would send to the workspace and putting those attachments on the default folder is a bad practice for document management for us. So far we are not planning to parse an email you would send to a workspace, but maybe you would be able to reuse a distribution list that is built on the collaboration platform. That was it for this one.
Okay.
From Davor, what about the possibility for multiple users to work on one document at the same time? This one is addressed by the last demonstration Jan did on that online content, and is part also of the online components are designing for 2018. Multiple users on the same time be addressed. What we are thinking about is a check-in, check-out mechanism to ensure that you will keep the version of the document. So like I start a document, I save it, then Jan open it, he save it. And we are working in the sequence, but we are ensuring that all the changes are tracked and we are proper version. Okay, from...
Yeah, just for the simultaneous online creation of a document, of course, we will keep the way of working as it's defined in the directives, and we will keep the way of working with the convener and with the working group. So we will align the tool very much to the way of how working groups and project teams are working.
From Jan Rietveld, will it be possible to number the documents automatically? There is a requirement for Senelec that we are looking right now, and that the idea now is not to create something specific for a stakeholder, but to ensure that what we do for a stakeholder is available for all stakeholders. So we'll look into it. For Jan Rietveld, you would like to give a specific format to that number, or this is just a unique number that you would like? Because as this is a database, we already have unique numbers per file, but they are currently hidden. For Senelec, they have a business reference that is currently built on a certain format, and we'll try to automate it and to see how other can use it to address the requirements.
Okay, so I see there's a question from Tara Mitchell. What will be the file size limitation for uploading? Well, these are some details we can discuss. She has been run into problems when trying to upload zip files containing multiple files. Of course, this will change because we are no longer hosting this in Geneva, but we will be moving to the cloud, which not only has an advantage in the speed of the tool. So one thing I didn't mention, we have, of course, the tool will be faster because it would not be hosted in Geneva, but it will be hosted in a safe cloud. But of course, we will also have advantages in the file upload. Then we have a question from Thomas Wegemann. What about unique document designation and support of pre-filling certain elements of the document number by the system? This is what we mentioned with vertical integration. So by vertically integrating also other tools like, for example, the Electropedia, we will have possibilities, especially in the online creation of documents, that while working on content that you can reference and you can see you can, for example, see files or definitions of files which are already existing. So you will be having more possibilities to pre-fill elements, and this you already see in the IEC project management which we are having. So this is another tool where now with the online forms, title and other things are pre-filled by the system. Then we have a question by Derek Johns. How many members of the reference group were from government, regulators, consumer groups and academia? We didn't count the groups. So we had people from government regulators, consumer groups, we had from academia, we also had members from conformity assessment, but this is not a political group, Derek, but it's more the users who are on a daily basis use it, and it has been open to everybody to join the group for all the users. So we had various groups. We had people from national committees. We had people from technical committees, from conformity assessments. So we made sure that there is a good variety of people. But So in principle, we had a good variety of people using. Then we have a comment from Valérie Demastieu. Files they have not created themselves. Okay, then we have a question from Jörg Weber. How is the cooperation with ISO? Will ISO make a use of our system also? Jörg, this is a good question. Here, I can say that ISO is participating in the CTF reference group, so ISO is also giving comments, and the head of IT of ISO is a part together with an IT project manager, has also access to the CTS reference group, to the staging test platform. This is one thing that we keep ISO in the loop here, and they can see the advantage and how we move forward. And this is not the only thing, of course, this XML project, which Cyril mentioned before here, we are also working together with ISO by using the NISO STS. So this we are in a dialogue with ISO on this. So offline, Valerie Demassieu, offline should always but offline should always be kept as an option because online may be difficult, if not impossible, in some meeting locations. This is something, of course, there will be more and more meeting locations with online possibilities. We are aware that there are still some meeting locations which do not have online access. So here we would, of course, recommend to have locations with online access, but you can, of course, create documents and then later drag and drop this into the file. This is probably now talking about the online creation of standards. So here, of course, if you work offline, you would not have all the possibilities of a vertical integration. So in the long run, we recommend to choose meeting locations with online access. But of course, you also have possibilities to create content and then later on fill it into the system. As to the mouse over question, the appropriate tooltip should be when you move mouse over to TC80, it should say wind turbines. Yes, this could be an option that if you move over that it shows the title of the committee. For the others, TC88, the title of the committee is wind turbines. So this would be one idea we could bring into the Agile project management. So Cyril is nodding. This could be something we look into. Thank you, Peter, for this idea. Then we have a comment from Yuka. Would it be possible to use the discussion feature to discuss documents at the National Mirror Committee level? And here I can say that yes, it is possible because we will be offering this tool also to national committees, which doesn't mean national committees have an obligation to use the tool, but it is an offer that not right now, but as soon as we have migrated it and the IEC committees start working, that national committees can also decide to use the tool for national level. And then, of course, the discussion feature would be one of the features as a part of the tool. So Thomas Wegmann is asking, what about the document circulation of CD to NC's committee draft? Will this be integrated into the system? This is something we are looking into. At the moment, not at the first stage. This will not be integrated at the first stage because, as mentioned, we are just migrating the set of functions we are having right now with the CTS. But of course, there is a possibility to look into this, but this is dependent on the requirements and the discussions with the national committees. So the framework allows the functionality, but it depends on the necessities of the national committees. Are you going to reintroduce the mail distribution list? Is a question from Filippo Frugoni. There will be notifications which will have the, in principle, the same function like a mail distribution list. So the notifications we are introducing will be comfortable and will probably be a better solution than the old mail replicator list we used to have. Ingvar Eriksson is asking, will a reference group also be set up for developing the online commenting tool? Well, online commenting tool, we are having right now the CTS reference group on this new IEC collaboration platform, and we are setting up these reference groups for large and large projects, like for example also for the XML project. The online commenting tool, I assume you mean the online standards creation tool, will be part of this whole project. So yes, we will work together, of course, with the users on this platform. Alfred Furrer is planned to integrate GoToMeeting into the platform. And here I can go back to the presentation or maybe just mention it, that we are looking into an assessment of real-time communication services. So it might not be GoToMeeting because this is an out-of-the-box tool we are using right now, but we are looking into possibilities of integrating some functionality, probably not GoToMeeting, but another possibility of online collaboration. Roland Hill is asking, will there be any language translation features in the future? Roland, at the IEC, we are, the working level is English. For standards, we have French as decided by the AFNO, by the National Committee of France, and Russian. But of course, providing the content in XML enables national committees to connect translation features. Mark Dillens is asking, will there be a possibility to search for documents based on their deadlines? This could be a functionality. So luckily, as we have possibilities to give deadlines and documents by using this new metadata, this would be one of the advantages we could look into. Yes, as soon as we have the metadata, we can also search for metadata. So Cyril again is nodding. So this would be another good idea. So you see, we are also collecting ideas here. It's good also to get your ideas through the questions. So this would be one possibility. I can see there's more questions. So let me just go down here. Okay, that was with the mouse. Just skip the, here we are. In the long term, are you going to abandon the word template? Question from Filippo Frugoni. Well, we are introducing the online collaboration, and in the background, we are also migrating we are creating all the existing content, the existing standards into XML. So in the long run, the idea is to have IEC standards in a database format to make use out of the numerous possibilities we have with this. So in the long run, probably we would no longer use the word template, because with the word template, still you have to fill in manually a lot of the information we already have in the database. And by using this online and having the possibilities of getting all this through vertical integration, all this information will facilitate the work a lot for secretaries, and will make standardization faster, because we will have less errors, we will have an easier way of working, we will better connect it to our project management, so probably this will be the case. Thierry Len, will there be a possibility for NC staff to access working group documents? This has in this level not yet been discussed. So we have the documents which are sent to the national committees, and these are the documents as defined in the directives. So these are all the stages, like committee draft and all the stages. This is a discussion we need to have on a political level, if the national committees have access to all working documents. Technically, this would be possible as soon as national committees are connected, but this would be another discussion on a higher level, I assume. And this would be also, because in principle, in these folders, in these working groups, you have a lot of discussion about travel, hotel, and the question is, do you want to have all these documents? But of course, in the long run, there would be possibilities to filter for documents, for filter for essential documents, since we will be adding the metadata right now. But this is up to discussion. So we have no more questions here. Cyril, do you see any other questions? No? Okay. So, if there are no more questions, I thank you very much for participating. We had a lot of participants today. Very happy for this. We will this afternoon do exactly the same webinar again to make sure that we have all time zones joining. I thank you very much for joining this, for your interest. You can ask questions per mail. You will have the possibility to get the slides, and we also recorded the meeting, so you will have the possibility to listen to the recording of the meeting. Thank you very much and have a nice day.